Zuccarello in pursuit, plays it back to Pietrangelo.
Well, it's been a long shift for Steele, and he looked to give the puck away to a defender.
Roy scores! Throws a long wrist shot from the high slot that beats Fleury, and Vegas has the game's first goal.
Well, that's what happened. Steele couldn't get off the ice, so instead of making a play, he flips it to the neutral zone, hoping to just get off, and quick transition allows Roy to pick this puck up in the middle of the ice. He's got some room, and then he just finds, it's a 3-on-3. Roy catches a break that goes off the skate of Addison. Looks like the shin pad of Addison, then through the five hole of Fleury. Those seem to be the bounces that the Wild are fighting right now.
Throughout this seven game homestand against some of the best in the league, couple division winners, leaders, five current playoff teams among the seven opponents for Minnesota.
That brings him on a quick 2-on-1 with Greenway. They go long body.
Steele was tangled up along the boards. Here comes Boldy. Wines, fire, saved by Thompson.
Well, movement without the puck, the key there. Nice feed from Gaudreau to a streaking Boldy all the way up the ice through two zones. Head up, slapper. Thompson with the cheater thumb of the blocker. It still has to be a volume game.
Underway in the second period. Howden. Goligoski across to Dumba. Foligno then put it right on the stick of Cotter coming back the other way. Cotter drops. Marchessault a shot. Knocked away by Fleury. Rebound clear to the line. Held by Pietrangelo. They score. Cotter with a tip from the high slot. And the turnover by Minnesota leads to a Vegas goal. It's 2-0 Golden Knights.
We asked Avison get into a rut like this, how much they end up costing you. Marcus Foligno with what looks like a clean exit gives it right back to Vegas. And then they get offensive zone time. Pietrangelo finds it at the point. Everybody over collapses trying to cover or recover from the turnover. And again, that's the second deflection from the high slot that has found its way through Marc-Andre Fleury's five hole.
Boldy picks it up for Minnesota. Spurgeon across to Middleton. Middleton moving in, fire, save Thompson. Spurgeon with a rebound chance. Thompson down. And the two Minnesota defensemen lead the rush for the Wild.
Just settles down. Middleton picks this up, and I think the Wild are making the right plays. They're shooting on these 2-on-1s. Middleton stops at the net.
Boldy plays it up high for Addison. Only goal Minnesota scored last night in Dallas was a power play goal. Thompson a sliding save. Rebound loose. Kaprizov scores!
Good job. Knowing when to screen, move, reposition the body to jump on a rebound. It's a moving screen, but then he's got the stick available to get that second chance. That forces Vegas to collapse. Rebound, they can't track it. And Kaprizov out in front. Smith checking his shoulder, gets lost. Absolutely loses Kaprizov. And then the puck ends up on his stick and in the back of the net. Perfect power play sequence from the Wild. They win the faceoff, they get the middle.
And it led to a power play goal for Minnesota. Stevenson moves in for Vegas. Centers, and a sliding stop by Fleury.
What a save, and maybe a game saver. Wow. Terrific save from Fleury.
Beats Minnesota within one with a terrific sliding save. 2-1 Vegas.
Came back, scored 3 points his first game, and then has only had two since. Really looking for offense.
Could be a 2-on-1 here for Vegas. Erickson catches up with a play, but Eichel still manages to get it to Cotter, who scores. And it's 3-1 Vegas.
Well, it's the extra effort. Catches him, but Eichel long reach, protects this one. Then he's got Erickson on the wrong side of him, but it's the patience, and he waits. That draws Fleury all the way to the post, throws it out to the slot. Followed up.
Dumba just did step up to keep that puck away from Stevenson, or he'd had a lone break. Now it's Smith working it along. Sliding stop by Fleury. Penalty coming against Minnesota on the play. And they're going to call a penalty shot.
This is being awarded a penalty shot for being slashed from behind on a breakaway.
I think it's just under the, just throwing him off enough to where he couldn't get a lot on the shot, but they award Smith the penalty shot, and here we go.
Riley Smith against Marc-Andre Fleury on the penalty shot. And he scores. Fleury thought he had it. It trickles through. And the penalty shot goal for Riley Smith makes it 4-1 Golden Knights.
Smith comes in on the forehand side. I think he turns that bottom hand over enough. That's where he gets it. Right under the toe of the stick of Fleury. Looking five hole. Spins it over. Comes over the top of that puck.
And Wild opponents now 1-for-3 on penalty shots this season.
Well, we talked to Evason, and he's always encouraged the D to be up in the play.
There's another odd man rush, and they score as Eichel beats Fleury, and it's 5-1.
Then tosses it, but Eichel, first point in 7 games. Now he's feeling good. Finds some room in the neutral zone. Accurate shot, good shooter, perfect placement. But again, for me, it's about the decision of the defense for the Wild. They want to be aggressive. They want to have 5 guys in. You're chasing it offensively. You're trying to manufacture it.
Fleury surrendered 5 goals on 23 Vegas shots through the first 40 minutes. And we're underway with the third. Centering pass, Boldy, kicked out by Thompson. Goodrow on the rebound. It was blocked, then he threw it right through the blue. Thompson down awkwardly for Vegas. Carrier tried to cut to the slot. Zuccarello on it there for Minnesota. He connects with Kaprizov. Kaprizov back to Zuccarello. Fires, pad save, Hill.
One spinorama something. But he pulls up. He knows he's got support coming. Over back check from Vegas.
White Cloud to Cotter at center ice. Eichel has Marchessault driving the net. And the pass just out of his reach.
The team's taking responsibility for it, and they're doing their best in the locker room to right the ship. Now the coach now has to step in and try to find a way.
Kessel in on the breakaway, saved by Gustafson.
That one was heavy and hard on the team, and just like a bad shift, you've got to turn the page as fast as you can. That game they couldn't.
Addison in, and a sliding stop by Hill. And this one comes to an end. The homestand starts with a one-sided loss to the Vegas Golden Knights. Vegas wins it by a final of 5-1.